Hi, my name is Traian Ionescu from ASCOM. I'm the Strategic Business Development Director, and I presented today capacity expansion based on the customer experience KPIs.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Traian Ionescu. I work from ASCOM in UK. And what ASCOM does, we optimize networks. That's what we do. I would like to talk to you today a bit about how we, from our experience in optimization, migrated to our customer experience in the last couple of, years. And that was basically a drive from the customer side. I'll talk to you a bit about a case study from Australia, from one of our best customers, Telstra. And then I will expose a little bit the methodology we use, which is a bit different than normal customer experience methodologies that are in place today. And I'll be happy to take your questions and feedbacks afterwards. And hopefully we'll make this in time for lunch. So the case study. We were working with Telstra in Australia for quite a number of years. And what I want to show you in here is basically how Telstra changed a bit the way in which they manage their network. And they changed the KPIs from the normal engineering KPIs towards customer experience KPIs. And what is important, why is that important for all of us, is the results that Telstra achieved are absolutely remarkable. I mean, I'm passionate and keen to talk to you about this, and please let me spend a bit more time in this particular slide. So first of all, Telstra uses a country which is quite massive in size and very sparsely populated. Yet, they become one of the most capex efficient companies in the world. In fact, in 2015, they were kind of becoming the most capex efficient per subscriber. So per capital per subscriber, they are the most efficient operator in the world, which is clearly remarkable. And also, they have the lowest churn rate in Australian market. And I'll come back to this low churn in a second. And not least, they are ranked by P3, so completely independently, they are ranked by this company, P3, which most of you, I think, heard of it. They are ranked like the next best network in the world. And guess what? Telstra achieved all those remarkable results, remarkable achievements, by actually spending about half, like for like, to what the number one operator in the world has spent. In addition to that, again, Telstra covers the entire Australian market, a continent, sparsely populated. Yet the number one operator, which I'm not going to name it, is one of the operators who covers a country in Central Europe. So I'll give you a couple of countries size to, for example, Switzerland, Czech Republic, Slovakia, Hungary, Austria, so countries like that. I mean, imagine, I think it's really mind-boggling. It's absolutely amazing to be the second best network in the world, covering an entire continent, sparsely populated, and you are only, if you're overtaken by the company who covers a small Central European country. I would expect somebody in a country like, Hungary to be the number one. I would expect, because it's a flat country, very populated, and so on and so forth. Well, no. And I hope I capture your attention with that. So, having the low churn in Australia, and I promise to come back to this point. Actually, the statement that our predecessors said, Joe, she was mentioning about the last kind of mile, the weakest link, if you want, in customer experience being the customer care guys that pick up the phone. So guess what? In our case in here, there is a proven fact that Telstra, they have the lowest number of customer care complaints, if you want, compared to the other guys. Not unexpected, given the fact that they have the lowest churn. And in the same time, another good interesting thing is that they charge slightly more than the other guys in Australia, than the competitors. So to charge a bit more, just like we discussed earlier, people are prepared to pay a little bit more for a better experience. Now, I'm not sure if they pay double compared to the other guys, or they pay 10% more. But anyhow, the trend of paying a little bit more for more quality is there, exists. So this slide I put in here just to make ourselves a little bit, to remind ourselves that we want to give customers a better experience, clearly. There is no question about that. But we want to keep things in balance. And in fact, we want to tilt this towards minimizing the capex and maximizing the profitability of the company. Because it's absolutely perfect if we have a company which is, you know, perceived as having a great customer experience. That's a good indicator, like we said earlier, for future profits. But we have to be still profitable. So this is where we have helped Telstra to really break the mold, if you want, and become a very successful company from that point of view. So, like we discussed, like I said, Telstra have introduced a new set of KPIs, which is actually customer-centric in their case. They don't look that much into the KPIs from the vendors, into call drop rates and stuff like that, for those of you who are familiar with these topics. And creating a new kind of approach where a single headroom metric, it's actually indicating how the customer perceives their services. Before they call the customer care, before everything else, they have a good service, that's what ensure that. And at the same time, this KPI is visible and very easy to be accessible all across the organization in Telstra, from the engineers all the way to the management. And in fact, the gentleman who is MD in basically he has responsibilities in RAN area, most of his success he's putting down to the fact that they embrace this new technology and this new approach in which we have been part to create it. The key thing is, apart from the customer experience being elevated and very well managed and monitored, the key is that Telstra is able to invest only in those sales that needs expansion. And this is a dramatical change compared to pretty much every other operator that I came across in the world. Most of the operators, they still do their expansion and their network management based on the KPIs from the counters, whereas we do the same, but based on the KPIs who monitor the customer service. So customer, you know, KPIs based. But this is a different approach, like I said, and sometimes that is difficult to explain when I talk to people from optimization as well. There is a little bit of a kind of, you know, really? We don't compare apple to apple in here, you know, from the optimization point of view. Our results are better in a long term, and the visibility that we create is massively improved. However, it's a very new approach, and basically what I want to say in here, in case there are any kind of, you know, optimization guys and ladies in the audience, is bear with us for a second. We'll get there eventually. Well, this is how Telstra methodology pretty much is described. It's more or less coming from the same, you know, idea like everybody else. We capture the CM and PM data, and from there, the difference is that we model each and every individual cell, and we capture all these kind of, you know, parameters, like, for example, soft capacity, radio resource management, access control, and so on and so forth. And we simulate this in a very sort of, you know, self-tuning, if you want, algorithm, in which we simulate even the, if you want, scheduler from different vendors, which guarantee to us the, if you want, the accuracy of our results. The key thing is here that we identify cells where the load causes the user experience to be degrading before that actually happened. And that's actually the key in here. So apart from the fact that we identify where we need to invest before the capacity exceeds the maximum, we also identify where loads causes user experience to be degraded. And that's a very important fact, because again, we can act, we give time to the operator to see when this particular cell should be expanded, or maybe we cannot expand it anymore, maybe we need a new cell, and so on. But we have a very good control from that point of view, which our customers will see and will appreciate as a good service at the end of the day. Okay, and a look at the growth forecast. Everybody in the operator can see which cell needs to be expanded in what particular day. I'm not sure if you can see right in here, but in this example element, we know that we have a headroom of 25%. So we are 25% away from actually breaking the customer experience barrier. And because of the growth of that particular cell in that particular region, we estimate that the expansion will be needed in 3 months. And this estimation is with very good accuracy, normally. This is a typical way in which we define, if you want, customer thresholds, customer experience KPIs. So we model all the services and we give them different kind of, you know, unacceptability from point of view probabilities. And this is at the core of the tool, and that is based on a lot of real life, if you want, experience and specifications. Okay, let me take a sip of water in the meantime. Any questions so far? Yes, please.
Can we go back to that chart, please? You said service unacceptability metric. I'm interested of your comments. How is that derived? Thank you.
So basically, this is derived from the operator, if you want, way in which they model different services. So we can expect that a call, for example, in LTE in Volte will have a different thresholds compared to, let's say, a voice call, normal voice call in RS-99 packet services, which is also different from the way in which we manage, let's say, HSPA and LTE downlink and downlink data. Well, customer is going to basically perceive the service.
Oh, this is a combination of
things. Yes. So this is how we model it in our tool. Yeah. And again, we can add more services, like for example, we discussed earlier about OTT services, like the gentleman, like Dogus said from Turkcell, or maybe Netflix users and so on and so forth. I mean, those things, this is just an example here. You know, I'm not going to defend or sustain that this is the best way to model it for your network. But the idea is that we can quantify each and every individual service. Like, for example, Netflix. Today, Netflix is not that much measured by the mobile operators, you know, because there is not a particular way to measure it. Well, we can do that in here. We can do and also measure it and also simulate it extremely accurate. Yeah. The specifications are different in that case. For example, we have to have a 90% probability over 1 megabit per second speed guaranteed. So you talk about probability and throughput. That's the correlation.
Thank you so much.
No worries, please. Okay, so what have we done in here? This is a lot of words in this slide, but the essence of it is basically that we maximize the customer experience for the largest number of customer, and hence the 90% 1 megabit, like we discussed earlier. And we want to do that with, and we do that actually, with the most effective use of the capital invested. Okay. At some point later, I guess somebody will ask me, how does this compare? How does our solution, how this use case from Telstra compares to the traditional, let's say, customer experience customer experience assurance products and services and so on and so forth? And the answer to this, which I'm sure somebody will ask me this question, let me anticipate it. We basically predict what is going to happen in the future. What's going to happen in 6 months, in 1 year, you can play with different scenarios. So Telstra does this every day. They not just measure, if you want, and quantify their exact customer experience in a daily basis. They can do it even hourly if they want to. But they can also see what's going to happen in this region or this part of the network in, let's say, 6 months from now. That's the difference to the existing if you own solution and so on solution and so on, who can improve your network, we can tell you what's going to happen right now in this cell right here. In other words, you know, a normal solution will tell you that outside there are 15 degrees, let's suppose, right? Great, that's very good, we need to know that. Or that is going to rain right now, it's raining right now. Well, we can tell you that it's going to rain in 6 months from now and it'll be maybe 15 degrees or 16 and so on. So that's pretty much the difference. This slide, this diagram, it's one that is monitored with great interest by the management and by the customer experience gentlemen there in Telstra.
it basically shows how much headroom they have in national level. So how far are they all the time to exceeding, if you know, the threshold of customer acceptance? And so that's a kind of, you know, helicopter sort of view of the network from customer experience perspective. In here, each and every individual engineer, they are looking into how much room, how much each individual headroom in their network have, and when do they need to expand that one. So that's how the things, you know, are, if you know, the visibility, how it's perceived at different level in the company. A normal, you know, cycle, if you want, of managing and expanding the network is describing here in this kind of, you know, intuitive picture. The headroom tile is the one that is measured, and then the capex budget, you know, accordingly, you know, adjusted. I'm pleased to tell you that in the first year of working with the tool, Telstra is their number, not mine, by the way. So Telstra reported a 38%. Reduction in the capex in the network. And if we think about it in, overall in the world, about 60% of the capex in a mobile network is used in the RAN area. So if we could save 38% of that and give you some better, you know, customer experience, I think that's a very interesting proposition, I believe, you know. Okay. We go a little bit into some details in here about how the customer experience, you know, is measured, and this is what we call an admission zone. So basically, you see, as long as your traffic is inside this blue area, everything is good and safe and nice. You don't have to do nothing about it. And again, the headroom is going to tell you have another 4.3 months until you need to expand your network. Your particular network element. There is a couple of algorithms, as you can see in here, in which we can generate this admission region, and we can calculate the headroom and calculate time to expansion for each individual network element. Next. We put here a bit of description in how the radio resource management works and what inputs do we need to create this. We start from the handover statistics, and we have radio resource management, radio resource, you know, statistics, traffic QS, and this is the one that, you know, our colleague asked in the back, how do we input that? And not least, we also implementing here the particular radio resource connection from different vendors. So you may have an Alcatel-Lucent versus, for example, an Ericsson or a Huawei and so on. They perform differently, actually. And we are able to measure and simulate this extremely accurately. All right. So this is an example of visibility and report. And I think we are just a little bit over time. There are a lot of details in here. If you don't mind, I'll probably skip them. And I'm much more happy to take your questions from now on rather than just go to the slides. I think the crux of the message that I want to transmit to you was already, you know, transferred. Anything that I can answer to? Oh, guess what? It was the last one. Thank you very much.